commando style. Laverne, you go secure the area behind those double doors. Hoagie, you take care of upstairs reconnaissance. I'll maintain command HQ here, in the lobby.
What are we looking for?
We've got to find where Dr. Fred is holding the tentacles.
This better not take too long. I've got an anatomy final tomorrow.
And I've got a show to set up later tonight. If I'm late, I don't get to test the drums.
If I know Dr. Fred, he's got the tentacles tied up in his secret lab. Question is, where's his secret lab?
So if you change the Sound Blaster to 16, usually most of the audio issues go away. Sound Blaster 2 is usually used to speed up the game. So I think this game, Sound Blaster 16 is better. Yeah, I can already see the difference. I don't really know how to play this game. So all these DOS games, you can download it from like abandonware.net or something like that. I'll leave the links in the description below. Okay, so moving on to, before we move on to the next game, I just wanted to mention one thing here. In order for Magic DosBox to recognize a folder, a directory, you have to make sure that the name of the folder should, name of the folder have to be less than 8 characters. So right now, this was complaining because this name was more than 8 characters, so let me just change this. Okay, so I changed the folder name to just monkey, and it works now. So I'm not hearing any audio here. I don't know if that's because I set it up wrong. Oh, I just heard it. Never mind. All right. Thank you. Now, I'm not sure how to zoom in this game. Anyway, that's SimCity 2000. Runs well. Oh, so I can't use the mouse cursor on this game. Looks like I'm only allowed to use the keyboard. The D-pad is right now mapped to keyboard arrow keys. And I mapped A as a enter, B as a escape. Anyway, it's running great. And this is a Princess Maker 2. And this game should only require mouse. And maybe a escape. Oh no. It does require arrow keys. Oh, I have to right click to go out of that page. Schedule, work, farm is the way to go. Work, farm. Gonna make me some money. Now don't do this in real life.
You must register.
Hmm. I got this from abandonware.net. Hold on, let me try again.
The flagship independence.
You must register.
Hmm. Wonder how I can advance. Enter. Oh. Ejected safely. Oh, okay, died. Sorry, I don't know how to play this game, but it looks like it's running well. Okay. This game is Sam and Max. An adventure game?
Friends? Friends? We've only gone out together 3 times, and already you're telling me you just want to be friends? You never gave me a chance, and for that, you'll fry like a pork sausage.
So Salmon Max, I think it's running also great. So there you have it. I played some DOS games. I'll show you how to set up these games. So mostly, it's pretty similar. So you want to use SVN Core, and this is a mapping C drive. So you could, I mapped it to a DOS folder, sorry, download folder, and I put all the DOS folders here. And make sure that these any of these folder name is less than 8 characters, otherwise Magic DOS can't use it. So let me just close this. You can set the memory to 32 and it works for the most of the time. Keep the CPU dynamic and performance automatic. And this is where you set the audio. So you can try different options. I've been using most of them as SB16, Sound Blaster 16. You can change it to SB2. I use SB2 on Doom, and it increased the performance. So use SB2 if you want to emulate it faster, but if you want to make sound quality better, then use SB16. And you can also change the frequency rate higher like this, and make sure that automatic performance is changed to cycles max. And this is where you set the main program. So navigate to each folder. So for example, I'm gonna play Doom, so I'm gonna do doom.exe. Click check and click here. So that's how you run a DOS game. So I'm gonna show you how to map these keys. So go to gamepad and tilt. And I've already added some keys here. And make sure that this is enabled. By default, it's enabled. So after enabling them, go to joystick. You can add more keys. So right now I'm in the mouse mode, so I'm gonna exit that, and let's bind ZL. So click that, and it detected L2, and get back to the mouse mode, and then click check. So now you have L2, but it's not bound to anything. So click none, and you can set this to a keypad or left click, right click, or show keyboard. So click keys, and if you want to bind this to, let's see, let's say A, you can do that. And now L2 is bound to a keyboard A, so when you click L2, it'll register as a keyboard A. And I set up D-pad as a keypad. Set left joystick as a mouse, so just click mouse. You can also change the mouse speed, dead zones. If the mouse speed is too fast, you can lower this value. Click check. Or you can set right joystick as a keypad. Right joystick as the mouse also. It's up for your preference. Oh, I guess you can't change, you can't do both as mouse. I think left is better because this is an analog stick and this is a digital stick, so you can use this as a mouse. It's up to you guys. And since there is no tilt for us, we'll leave that out. Also, I mapped L1 as left click, right, R1 to the right click, But I think now that I'm thinking about this, A can be a click too, but it's up to you guys. So, okay, so let me turn off the mouse mode. Okay. New game. So there you have it. So you can always enter the menu and you can do a save state, load state on Magic DOS. So that's pretty useful. If you need to access the keyboard, if you click here, it accesses the regular Magic DOS keyboard. If you click here, it just accesses the Android keyboard, whatever you have set. So let me hide that. So that's it. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye.